Hello, it's Christine here from MDA with some grant application writing tips. So, you've identified the need for a grant, you have a proposed project idea, you've researched and selected a funding opportunity, and now it's time to write the application. Writing grant applications can be a particularly scary prospect, especially if English is our second or third language. But I'd like to share some writing advice with you today in order to strengthen your application and increase the likelihood of success. Writing tip number one, answer the question. Yes, that may seem a little obvious, but you'd be surprised by the number of applicants who don't read the question properly. This is the number one reason why applications are rejected. Grant makers receive hundreds, if not thousands, of applications. So make it easy for them. Make them remember you. Make them want to keep on reading by answering the question they ask of you and demonstrating how you meet their criteria by using solid examples. Writing tip number two, language. Be clear, concise, and professional. Avoid slang and jargon. Refer to your organization's name at least once in each answer. If you're up against character limitations in your answer box, then use bullet points. Use British English, not American English. Jump into the language preferences section of your system and ensure that British English is selected as the default. Make sure you're using the same key vocabulary and phrases in your answers that the grant maker is using in their funding guidelines to create that synthesis between the aims of your project and the aims of the grant maker. And when writing the application, keep that grant maker in mind as a collaborative partner committed to the same cause. Use the active voice. Improve your sentences by changing passive sentences into active sentences. The passive voice is particularly deadly in grant proposals. Those of us who work in the not-for-profit arena think we should be modest and not sell our organizational achievements and successes, but this is not the case when writing grant proposals. Use the active voice. It takes fewer words and gives your writing more power. So, for example, instead of writing 2,000 meals were cooked by us, use the active voice and write, "We cooked 2,000 meals." Writing tip number three, proofreading. Have your submission proofread by a neutral party, either by someone outside of the organization, such as myself here at MDA, that's what I'm here for, or someone within your organization who's not been directly involved in the application process. And ask them, have we made a compelling case for funding? So, in summary, answer the question, use appropriate language, and have it proofread. A well-written proposal is a key factor in the decision-making process of the panel. Until next time, bye-bye.